index, optimal operating temperature, loss of autonomy at high temperature, loss of autonomy at low temperature, heat pump, cold recharge. Real cases Oslo. Real cases Chicago. Measures to adopt. Subscribe to the Fleet Management channel. Your subscription is a great support to continue making new videos. Subscribe. 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 Optimal operating temperature. The optimal operating temperature of the electric vehicle battery is in the range of 15-30 degrees Celsius. Vehicle manufacturers test their electric cars in extreme climates because they are very sensitive to both high and very low temperatures. This affects the range of autonomy, which can drop drastically if we abuse the air conditioning systems. In high temperatures to lower the cabin temperature, and in low temperatures to raise the cabin temperature. The main consequence is the loss of vehicle autonomy. Therefore, the vehicle will not have the necessary autonomy to provide the service. High temperature. The ideal operating temperature of a battery in an electric car is closer to extreme heat than extreme cold. In addition, it is easier to refrigerate if necessary. Therefore, the effort made by the car is less in summer than in winter. The high temperature generates a decomposition of the electrolyte, causing the formation of dendrites and a loss of active material in the anode. The result is a loss of battery capacity and increases the impedance, increasing energy consumption and a decrease in autonomy. It is very important that the vehicle has liquid cooling of the battery, since the battery in operation is in the appropriate temperature range. Low temperature. Low temperatures cause the loss of electrical contact, the formation of dendrites, and the degradation and breakage of graphite. The result is a loss of active material in the cathode, decreasing the capacity of the battery and increasing the impedance, increasing energy consumption. Cold temperatures slow down the charging rate, temporarily reducing range. The colder it is, the more energy the car consumes to maintain not only the temperature of the cabin, but also that of its battery, so that it is able to work in optimal conditions. Due to lower battery performance and higher energy consumption, the range of an electric car can decrease by between 20% and 30% when it is cold.
Learned about our fleet management consulting and training services. Reduce costs and optimize fleet management activities. We electrify your fleet of vehicles. We carry out the electrification plan until its implementation, known as
loss of autonomy at high temperature. The consulting firm Recurrent Auto has analyzed the data of 7,500 electric vehicles in search of the answer about autonomy in summer and underlying concerns about the impact of heat on it. Air conditioning has much less negative impact on the range of an electric car than a resistance heater, so generally speaking, the range loss will be less than in winter. According to the data, vehicles will not begin to notice this loss of autonomy until at least 30 degrees Celsius. Another important fact is that the difference between the ideal interior temperature and the outside temperature is usually lower in summer than in winter, and air conditioning has much less negative impact on the range of an electric vehicle than a resistance heater. So in general terms, the range loss will be less than in winter. With the data collected, driving with an interior temperature of 21 degrees Celsius, the batteries lose an average autonomy of 2.8% at 26 degrees Celsius, 5% at 32 degrees Celsius, 31% at 37 degrees Celsius. It must be taken into account that Recurrent Auto points out that the average loss of autonomy at 37 degrees Celsius is approximate, since the data collected is lower, since drivers prioritize traveling first and last hour of the day when temperatures are milder. Translated into data, it may take between 3 kilowatts and 5 kilowatts to bring a vehicle at 35 degrees Celsius to a comfortable temperature, but only about 1 kilowatts is needed to keep it at 21 degrees Celsius. But this is the average result. Each model has its own design and characteristics that make performance in cold or hot climates different. In the case of Tesla, the differences when temperatures rise are minimal. The graph shows an almost horizontal line that means that autonomy is not impacted when the heat increases. They do not show exactly what percentage affects each model of those studied, but they do point out some important differences. For example, in the Tesla Model 3, Model Y, Model S, and Model X, the loss of autonomy is minimal. According to their data, maintaining a comfortable temperature between 21 degrees Celsius and 23 degrees Celsius in these models can translate into a consumption of between 1 kilowatts and 3 kilowatts, although it can reach 6 kilowatts. Among the conclusions of the study, in addition to verifying that logically older vehicles manage heat worse than newer models, Recurrent Auto points out that traveling in summer with the air conditioning on affects the autonomy of an electric car less than traveling in winter with the heating. But other models are not as efficient. And for example, we can see how the Nissan Leaf has a more irregular line, with a notable loss of autonomy when the outside temperature rises above 30 degrees Celsius. In the case of the Ford Mustang Mach-E, it has a more efficient system that also has a sensor that automatically adapts the effort of the air conditioning compressor to offer the best performance in each case, something that allows it to maintain autonomy up to at least 35 degrees Celsius degrees. The key is that the temperature difference between the inside of the car and the outside in summer is usually less than in winter. In winter, heating the passenger compartment from a very low temperature to a comfortable temperature requires more energy than cooling it from a high temperature to a comfortable temperature in summer. In all cases, it is recommended to precondition the cabin before leaving. In this way, the vehicle's interior temperature will decrease and the effort and consumption will be less once started. Furthermore, the study states that in summer, the use of air conditioning in an electric car does not significantly affect its autonomy compared to gasoline cars and their air conditioning. This will depend a lot on the model of car in question, but it means that while in gasoline vehicles, the air conditioning must work against the residual heat of the engine, in electric cars, there is not as much additional heat generated while the car is in motion, so the air conditioning does not consume as much. It must be taken into account that when taking a trip by electric car in summer, the risk of overheating of the battery increases. Beyond 45 degrees Celsius, 50 degrees Celsius, the electronic components of the battery deteriorate faster and become damaged. Notice a drop in charging performance. Thus, as the battery approaches the overheating point, the charging speed decreases, since the battery management system adapts the charging rate to the temperature. The most advisable thing is to precondition the temperature inside the passenger compartment before leaving whenever possible, park in the shade, drive as efficiently as possible, and plan your stops very well. Loss of autonomy at low temperature. The consulting firm Recurrent Auto has analyzed the data of 10,000 electric vehicles in search of the answer about autonomy in low temperatures. 18 most popular electric models in the US market have been tested. The study was carried out during the 2022-2023 winter season. All vehicles have had a decrease in their autonomy. The approved figures vary greatly with those obtained in the real world. The average of the analysis has remained at a reduction of 29.7%, but some vehicles have stood out above the rest. The worst results in the sample correspond to the Volkswagen ID.4. The German manufacturer's car batteries lose 46% of their total charge capacity when temperatures drop. Next, the Hyundai Kona, Ford Mustang Mach-E, and 2015 Nissan Leaf are the other models experiencing above-average losses. The charging capacity of the batteries of these three cars only reaches 66% in winter. Behind them, we find a wide variety of models, among which the Tesla Model Y, Model 3, and Model X stand out, all three with a loss of 24%. The Audi e-tron is the most efficient vehicle in the cold, with a loss of 16% compared to its standard range. Loss of autonomy at low temperature. Annually, Motor.no magazine carries out a study in Norway in which it pits different electric cars against an autonomy test in extreme cold. The objective is to check which car goes the furthest in real driving conditions. To compare it with the WLTP cycle figures and know what the differences are, There have been 23 models compared. The list of participants includes well-known names such as the Volkswagen ID.7, the Tesla Model 3 Long Range, Hi-Fi Z, the Lotus Eletre, or the XPeng G9, many of them from China. The conditions have been exactly the same for the 23 vehicles in the comparison. The test is actually quite simple. Drive the cars until they stop due to lack of charge. Outside, temperatures between minus 1 degree Celsius and minus 5 degrees Celsius. And not only on planes, as the test took place in the mountainous region of Dovrefjell. The final objective is to compare the discrepancies between the factory-approved autonomy and the real one. This can be a problem for cars with a higher official rank. All vehicles have had a decrease in their autonomy, affecting some more than others. The unknown Hi-Fi Z is the one that has won a more than deserved victory, which has managed to equate the real figures with the theoretical ones, just a deviation of 6%. The Lotus Eletre has been another of the big winners, being able to complete a trip of 465 kilometers of the 530 kilometers announced in its technical sheet. The Tesla Model 3 Long Range has been one of the most affected by the cold. With a homologation of 629 kilometers, it has only been able to complete 441 kilometers, 29.9% less. The Polestar 2 LR suffers from a 30% deviation, while the Volvo C40 shoots up to a 31.5% range discrepancy. The worst result of all is for the Toyota BZ4X. The Japanese brand's first electric SUV has barely been able to complete a trip of 313 kilometers of the 460 kilometers officially announced. Heat pump. The heat pump is a reverse air conditioning system that allows the residual heat of the electrical components to be used to air condition the passenger compartment. If the electric car has a heat pump, it is not necessary to demand as much energy from the battery to acclimatize the interior. But, even if it equips this component, the autonomy at sub-zero temperatures is lower than that achieved in less extreme weather. Their two great advantages are that they can operate in both directions, providing heating or cooling of the cabin air. However, most can only operate in a limited temperature range, such as when it is too cold outside. With extreme temperatures, they become less efficient. It is composed of a compressor, an evaporator, and a condenser. The heat pump captures waste heat emitted by electricity modules such as traction motors, onboard chargers, and inverters, and also from the battery pack and internal charger itself. The system uses the heat generated by these components to vaporize the refrigerant from liquid to gas. The high-pressure gas is discharged from the compressor to the condenser to be converted back into liquid. This process generates additional thermal energy that is recovered by the heat pump and used to heat the cabin. This captured energy improves the efficiency of the heating, ventilation, and air conditioning system. Heating, ventilation, and air conditioning management system, recycling it to more efficiently heat the passenger compartment and minimize battery energy consumption. By reducing the battery charge, the heat pump reduces the energy consumption of the heating, ventilation, and air conditioning system, maximizing the car's available electric driving range. Heat pump. With a heat pump, we can achieve at least 10% energy savings. The consulting firm Recurrent Auto has carried out a study to find out how much autonomy is lost using a heat pump or resistance heating. In all cases, the loss of autonomy using a heat pump is less than using resistance heating.